Good morning, Savanna. I'm Gio, and welcome to another episode of Gio's Tech, where I kind of give you a little bit of a behind-the-scenes take on the streaming and gaming setup that I've got here. So for today, it's going to be a pretty quick one. We've just got a new update from the Loop Deck team. A new iteration of the software has dropped with a whole bunch of fixes and some UI updates. Another few updates that go a long way to making this even better than it was before. So let's jump into it. First of all, you'll need to jump over to the Loop Deck page. I'll link it below. Next, head on over to the downloads page and either download the macOS or the Windows version, whichever is obviously suitable for you. There are the previous versions available still as well. So if you're working on I believe there's an issue with Razer products at the moment, so if you've got a Razer deck, you need to go and download the older 5.91. There's still a few little bugs to be worked out, but I believe that's in the known issues. And then once you've done that, download it and run through the install, and you'll be ready to go in no time. So as far as patch notes go, there's just a couple of new builds. Like I mentioned before, the Razer and Steam controller, the Razer Stream controllers are still not functioning properly with the new updates. So jump back into the 5.91 for now and then come back when they've fixed it. It's a bit annoying, but these things do happen. It'll be all right. As far as updates go, we've got software support for new bits and pieces. All of the plugins have new updated bits and pieces in them, so let's go through them, shall we? As far as general improvements go, new installers for Mac and Windows, we've already been through this, rebranded the core software to Logitech Plugin Service. So now Logitech have their own Stream Deck company, I guess. Which, I mean, isn't a bad thing, they're a good company. Let's see how they build on this from here. So there's a couple of main things, a reduction to application startup time and a reduced CPU usage and idle. I've noticed this huge amount since I've been using it over the last couple of days, or day and a half since it dropped. You can install plugins now without having to restart the app, which is a really good feature. We've got decoupled plugins from the core app, making them installable via the marketplace, so you don't end up getting stuck with things that you don't want. You can go in and download the ones you want, basically. Added Italian and Spanish support, always good. I speak a bit of both, but that's kind of here nor there. Added support for .NET 8 plugin SDK, allowing plugin developers to leverage this latest C# language features. So added additional bits and pieces. We'll see what comes out of this in the coming few weeks. Hopefully some new plugins will be kind of fun. A few updates to the error messages. I can't remember ever seeing these, but they're changed now, I guess. Real-time value synchronization has been implemented for dial actions, allowing users to observe the adjustments as they are made. Initially available for a select number of adjustments, so as you're doing it, you can see what they come up as they happen while you're actually, you know, setting them up, basically, rather than actually operating them. Updates to the UI. So Loop Deck now supports .NET 8 plugin installation without requiring a service restart, which is, you know, it's something, it's handy. It just means you don't have to repeatedly restart it every time you install a plugin, so that's kind of good. Rename the Loop Deck UI executable to loopdeck.exe on Windows, so, you know, just a few renaming things. Copy version button about the Loop Deck now copies both the UI and LPS versions to the clipboard. Icons and icon editor, default icon and icon background colors for plugins and system actions. Implement a new icon system for the default font and default font. One thing I did notice, which I'll show you in a bit, is they've added a drop-down menu for the fonts that actually you can now see all of the fonts available without having to scroll through. Added hover state for the icons to enhance user experience. Remove the Loop Deck media icons icon pack from the installer and added them to the Loop Deck marketplace. Added new default icon pack to the install. So a few little default icon packs changed. We'll figure it out when we get there. Plugin services, we don't really need to look at that. Plugin improvements. Improved application plugin installation flow and speed. We saw that. I mentioned the CPU usage before. Enhanced plugin loading, again, that really works well. Since the change, it's been quite noticeable. If the plugin is not connected to the client app, a warning message / icon is displayed on the button, which it had before for some of them, but some of them didn't work. So it's kind of hard to tell which was working and which wasn't. But you get a warning logo on the Stream Deck itself, on the icons on the Stream Deck, so that's a good one. A few plugins in installer, key ones, I guess, for us. Twitch changed the plugin author to Logitech, updated .NET 8, we've been through that. Icon style has been, the default icon style has been changed, and updated support, the support page now links to Logitech. OBS Studio is another good one, changed the plugin author to Logitech, again, update to the .NET 8, and updated the default icon style. There's a few bug fixes. If you want to read those, welcome to known issues. Again, we talked about a few of the known issues. These are some of them that are kind of out of the scope for this kind of video, but just thought I'd go through them quickly. There's a few really good updates in there, and I guess let's jump over to have a look at the actual loot deck, shall we? So, things have changed a little bit, not by much. You can see now the icons that no longer work or are off have a little exclamation mark next to them. Actually not available. This one I need to update because I believe it is one of my Discord notification ones. So when Discord actually opens up, it'll pop up there. So we'll activate all those. None of them are actually working at the moment. I'd need a restart again for the OBS Studio one. I've just reinstalled everything at the moment. So I'm still actually putting things back together, which is fun and tricky. One thing I'd recommend before you install this is to save and export your original profile so that you can import it back in after you've reinstalled the new software. It's just a kind of a fail-safe, always kind of handy. So I've got Libre Hardware Monitor running in the background. You can see we've got a button to actually open it and start it. Always good, handy, right, the touch of a button. And a couple of graphs in here. We've got our CPU and memory. We've also got ability to check in on clock speed from the CPU. Oh, bus speed at 100 megahertz. CPU total load. We've obviously got that as a graph as well. You know, kind of handy to look at both. CPU temps, both total die and total core. We've got CPU temps, so it's always handy. Now, this is one that I didn't have before. I was using MoBros, and it's just handy having something like this I can just switch over to. See the load on my while I'm streaming and while I'm playing games. It's always kind of handy just to have a visual there, especially with the couple of graphs. It would be nice to see more integration from this because Libre Hardware Monitor has so much available to it. All the data you could possibly need. It's fantastic. This isn't a video about that, so we won't go into it. We've got our usual Twitch buttons that we can add in, so we can go to, where are we gonna go? Let's go here. An emotes only chat, followers only chat. Ooh, we can add in, oh, this is good. Let's go for followers for an hour. Save, beautiful. So this is what I'm talking about with the updated default icons, which is like really quite nice actually. Create clip, it's always handy. I changed the create clip default icon, so I like this one. Yeah, that's cool. Run commercial, send chat message, all that sort of. View account, always quite a low number on my stream, so you know, if you ever want to come by and you know, increase that number, it's always handy to have. So yeah, there, anyway, just a quick little run through of a few little updates on the loop deck software and a few of the little bug fixes and things like that. Like I said again, do make sure that you export your profile prior to installing the software and then import it afterwards. It's always handy. So anyway, thank you for watching. I really appreciate your time and thank you for the support so far on the channel. It's been fun. If you want to see any of the gaming side of things, please feel free to drop by the gaming channel, or you can come by the Discord as well. I've got a Discord. We've got a Discord. Got some good friends in there. We do a bit of tech support every now and again. Lots of gaming chat and hilarity a lot of the time. Yeah, most of the time. Some people are funnier than others, right? And drop by the stream if you ever feel like you want to ask some questions in person. I am streaming Mondays and Fridays over Twitch and on YouTube as well. So right here. Actually, generally on the Geo channel. So go see that first. And then if I'm not there, come back and say hi here. Anyway, all that remains for me to say is kakite ana, kia ata whai, stay safe, be kind, and I'll catch you in the next one. See you.